Hello everyone, this is our 8th lecture on the course titled Fluid Mechanics 2, and this is our continued lecture of the previous 7th lecture, that is numerical based on drag force and lift force. So let's continue with our numerical. This is our third numerical. The statement is given: a kite weighing 9.8 newton and having area of 1 meter square makes an angle of 7 degree to the horizontal when flying in a wind of 36 km per hour. That is a kite which is given having weight of 9.8 newton and area of 1 meter square making an angle with respect to the horizontal when it is flying in a wind, and the velocity of wind is given as 36 km per hour. If pull on the string which is attached to the kite is 49 newton. So whatever the string is which is attached to the kite, the pull is made on that string, and the magnitude of that pull is 49 newton, and that string is inclined to the horizontal at 45 degree, then calculate lift force, lift and drag coefficients. Take value of density for the air as 1.2 kg per meter cube. So they asked to calculate lift coefficient of drag force and lift force, that is CD and CL. They asked to calculate. They haven't given drag force and lift force. They have given some other things like say weight of kite, area of kite, and its inclination with respect to the horizontal. Also inclination of that particular pull which is made on that particular kite by using string which is attached to that kite. And the value of that pull is 49 newton. They have also given the wind speed, 36 km per hour. They have also given the density, but they haven't given drag force and lift force. So we need to calculate first drag force and lift force, then we can calculate drag coefficient and lift coefficient. So let's start with the given data. Area of kite, which is given as 1 meter square. Total weight of the kite is given as 9.8 newton. Velocity is given as 36 km per hour. Just simply convert it into a meter per second, which is coming out as 10 meter per second. Angle made by kite with respect to horizontal as 7 degree. Angle made by string. Sorry, here it is again. There's some small mistake here. It's not a kite. It's an angle made by string with respect to the horizontal as 45 degree, and pull made on the string as 49 newton. The density of air is given as 1.2 kg per meter cube. Now we are going to solve this numerical. For the computation of drag force and lift force, we need to draw a free body diagram for the given statement. So whatever the statement they have given, we need to draw a free body diagram. So once we draw the free body diagram, we can easily compute drag force and lift force. And then after we can solve, we can compute, we can calculate coefficient of drag and coefficient of lift. So here we have drawn the free body diagram for the kite, which is flying in the air and making an angle with respect to the horizontal. So here it is kite, which is making an angle with respect to horizontal as 7 degree. And this is the pull, which is also making an angle 45 degree with respect to the horizontal. Now, whatever the forces which are acting on the kite, just we will draw here. That is a free body diagram we are going to complete here. The weight component of kite acting downward direction having value of 9.8 newton. Again, pull is made on the string and having magnitude of 49 newton. And this pull is acting at an 45 degree with respect to the horizontal. So I am just going to resolve this pull component in two direction. One is acting in direction of motion or in the wind speed or with respect to the horizontal, and another is acting in normal to the direction of motion. So here it is P cos of 45 and P sine of 45. As we are measuring angle with respect to the horizontal, I am going to take horizontal as a cos, vertical as a sine. Now the kite, which is also making an angle 7 degree with respect to the horizontal, and here we have completed our free body diagram. This is the air which is moving with the velocity 10 meter per second, that is uniform velocity we are considering here. After completing this free body diagram, we can easily compute our drag force and lift force. We know that our drag force is that force which is acting along the direction of motion, and lift force as the component of total force which is acting normal to the direction of motion. So we can simply calculate our drag force and lift force, which are acting on the this particular kite. So we know that drag force acting on the kite will be given by the equation sum of forces which is acting in direction of motion. Now what are the forces which are acting in direction of motion? So there is only one force which is acting in direction of motion, that is P cos of 45. So here it is, Fd will be given by P cos of 45. So here we are going to take the component of forces which are acting in x direction. So here it is, Fd is equal to P cos of 45, my drag force which is coming out as 34.65 newton. Now the next, I can compute the coefficient of drag by using equation. Fd is equal to Cd multiplied by A multiplied by rho u square upon 2. All the values we know. Area is given as 1 meter square. Density is given. Velocity is also given. We can simply put those values and we can calculate our drag coefficient. So my drag coefficient coming out as 0.577. As it is dimensionless, no need to write down any unit. Just we will calculate now lift coefficient. Again, for the calculation of lift coefficient, first we need to calculate the lift forces, lift force which is acting on the kite. So it will be the sum of all forces which are acting in direction normal to the direction of motion. So we know that what are the forces which are acting in normal to the direction of motion. The first one is the weight component which is acting downward. Another is the component of pull which is acting in vertical direction. By adding those two, we will get the value of lift force. So here it is, my value of lift force is coming out as 44.45 newton. As both forces are acting in same direction, I have directly taken their addition. Because no need to mention negative sign, because both are acting in downward direction, so both will be get added. And here my lift force is coming out as 44.45 newton, and by using lift expression I can simply calculate value of CD which is coming out as 0.741. by putting the value of those all parameter in the equation of lift force, I can simply calculate the value of coefficient of lift. Let's move to the next numerical. A body has a length of 3.5 meter and projected area of 2.8 meter square normal to the direction of its motion. So here directly a projected area of the body is given, and that projected area is measured perpendicular to the direction of motion, and that body is having length 3.5 meters. So length separately given and area is also given. The body moves through a water medium having viscosity. So they haven't given velocity, but they have given viscosity as 0.01 poise. Find drag on the body if it has value of CD as 0.25 at Reynolds number 5 multiplied by 10^6. Now this is somehow tricky numerical, because they haven't given velocity, they only given the coefficient of drag, and they have given viscosity, they have given Reynolds number, and they have given length as well, they have given projected area, and they asked to calculate drag force. Now while calculating the drag force, we need a value of velocity, that is we need a u. If we don't have u, we cannot calculate our drag force. So for the calculation of u, just look at the numerical from where you can calculate. The most important thing they have mentioned in the numerical, that is Reynolds number. Now they have given value of CD for the Reynolds number at 5 × 10⁶. If they have given Reynolds number, it might have some specific reason. Just we will simply write down the equation for Reynolds number, which is given by expression rho v l divided by mu. So what you are getting here, if I am considering value of Reynolds number at which the CD is measured, so if we are going to make use of value of CD as 0.25, then in that case we need to consider value of Reynolds number as 5 × 10⁶. So if I put that value here in this Reynolds number, then I can simply calculate velocity u. But we know that density, as it is given water, so density of water is 1000. Length of the body is given as 3.5 meter. mu viscosity. Viscosity is also mentioned. So by using Reynolds number, you can compute the velocity. So we will simply calculate velocity by using Reynolds number, and we will calculate the drag force which is acting on the body. So first thing, write down all the given data. Given is the area is given, 2.8 meter square. Now mu is given, which is given in terms of poise. We are going to convert it into newton second per meter square by dividing it with 10. So it is coming out 0.001 newton second per meter square. CD is given 0.25 at Reynolds number is equal to 5 into 10 to the power 6. Now by using Reynolds number, rho UL upon mu, we are going to compute the velocity. So my velocity, which is coming out as 1.43 meter per second. Now I am simply going to use this value of u in the expression for the drag force, which is given by CD multiplied by A multiplied by dynamic pressure, that is rho u square upon 2. And by putting all those values, I will get the value of drag force as 571.42 Newton. So this is answer. Hope you understood all those numerical. We have solved total 4 numerical. I will give you the assignment separately, so you will get you will have a practice to solving the numerical. If you have any question, queries, you can ask it. Thank you for watching.